हाय गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू यूट्यूब चैनल केमिस्ट्री लाइव UGPG। सो टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट एस्टिमेशन ऑफ आयरन टू एंड आयरन थ्री इन ए मिक्सचर बाय स्टैंडर्ड पोटासियम डाइक्रोमेट सॉल्यूशन। सो दिस इज हाईली बेनिफिशियल फॉर BSc एंड MSc केमिस्ट्री स्टूडेंट्स अंडर CBSE सिलेबस। सो आई हैव ए सिंपल मैसेज फॉर यू, ऑलवेज थिंक फॉर इनोवेशन, ऑलवेज बी क्रिएटिव, लर्न स्मार्टली एवरीवेयर एनी टाइम एंड हेल्प टू लर्न अदर्स। सो देर इज द डिस्क्लेमर अबाउट दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट। इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट अप्रोक्सीमेट डाटा आर यूज टू गिव ए फ्लेवर अबाउट द रियल एक्सपेरिमेंट, कैलकुलेशन पार्ट एंड कंक्लूजन, एंड बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द रियल एक्सपेरिमेंट टू द स्टूडेंट्स। इफ यू कैरी आउट द रियल एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन योर ओन, यू विल गेट योर ओरिजिनल डाटा फॉर योर एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड इट मे हैपन दैट द रिजल्ट मे वेरी फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन। द एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू एस्टिमेट द आयरन टू एंड आयरन थ्री यूजिंग स्टैंडर्ड पोटासियम डाइक्रोमेट सोल्यूशन। सो वट आर द अपराटस रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट? ब्यूरेट एंड विथ ब्यूरेट स्टैंड, पीपेट, पीपेट बॉल, कॉनिकल फ्लास्क, ग्रेजुएटेड सिलेंडर, बीकर, वॉल्यूमेट्रिक फ्लास्क एंड वाश बॉटल। सो दीज आर द फिगर्स ऑफ अपराटस और थिंग्स यूज इन टाइट्रेशन एक्सपेरिमेंट। सो वी नीड ए ब्यूरेट, पीपेट, कॉनिकल फ्लास्क, बीकर, सो वी नीड टू वॉश ऑल दिस ग्लासवेयर्स, वॉल्यूमेट्रिक फ्लास्क, मेजरिंग सिलेंडर बिफोर यूजिंग इन टाइट्रेशन। देन वी नीड टू रिंस द ब्यूरेट एंड पाइपेट टू टू थ्री टाइम्स इन द सॉल्यूशन दैट वी वांट टू टेक इन द ब्यूरेट एंड इन पाइपेट। बाई यूजिंग द पाइपेट बॉल यू कैन सॉक द सॉल्यूशन इन पाइपेट। Similarly, you can use glassware, use wash bottle to clean the glassware. You can use weighing machine to take the exact weight of chemicals. And while heating the solution, you need Bunsen burner. And if you need some filtration, you need glass funnel and filter paper. So, what are the chemicals required for this experiment? N/10 potassium dichromate solution, ferrous and ferric solution, stock solution, 6 normal sulfuric acid solution, एन फिनाइल एंथ्रानिलिक एसिड एज इंडिकेटर, कॉन्सेंट्रेट HCl, कॉन्सेंट्रेट स्टानस क्लोराइड सोल्यूशन एंड सैचुरेटेड HgCl2 सोल्यूशन। सो व्हाट इज द बेसिक थ्योरी और प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड दिस टाइट्रेशन? सो व्हेन आयरन टू इन द मिक्सर सोल्यूशन इज टाइट्रेटेड अगेंस्ट स्टैंडर्ड पोटासियम डाइक्रोमेट सोल्यूशन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, Cr2O7 2- विल बी रिड्यूस टू Cr3+ and Fe2+ will be oxidized to Fe3+. So ferrous is oxidized to ferric ion. So if you look at the chemical reactions, K2Cr2O7 ionizes to give rise to 2 potassium ion and Cr2O7 2-. And this Cr2O7 2- is reduced in presence of 14H+ ions by accepting 6 number of electrons to Cr3+. So in this reaction, 6 number of electrons are in business. And in case of iron that is oxidized to iron 3+, only 1 electron is released. So the net chemical reaction is Cr2O7 2- plus 14H+ plus 6 electron plus 6 Fe2+, giving rise to 2 Cr3+, 7 water plus 6 Fe3+. So from titration value, the amount of ferrous ion present in the mixture can be estimated. And while calculating the total iron, so when Fe3+ ion in the mixture solution is titrated against standard potassium dichromate solution, it does not react. So what we have to do? So Fe3+ solution must be reduced to Fe3+. Only Fe2+ ion will react with potassium dichromate solution by using stannous chloride SnCl2 in presence of concentrated HCl. So in solution we get the total iron in present in the mixer solution in the form of Fe2+ ion. So whatever Fe3+ ferric iron present in the solution, that must be reduced to Fe2+ ferrous iron. So what are the chemical reactions involved? So SnCl2, so here Sn2+ is oxidized to Sn4+, releasing 2 number of electrons. And Fe3+ will be reduced to Fe2+ by accepting 1 electron. So the net chemical reaction will be Cr2O7 2- plus 14H+ plus 6 electron plus 6 Fe2+, giving rise to 2 Cr3+, plus 7 water plus 6 Fe3+. So from titration value, the amount of total iron present in the mixture can be estimated. So when we want to prepare 0.1 normal potassium dichromate, so in this, from the reaction we have seen, the 6 number of electrons are involved here. So its equivalent weight of potassium dichromate will be molecular weight by the number of electrons involved, that is 6, so that will be 49 gram. So we can prepare 0.1 normal potassium dichromate solution by dissolving about 1.225 gram of potassium dichromate by dissolving in 250 ml of distilled water in volumetric flask. So what is the exact procedure? So you have to transfer the total iron solution supplied to a 250 ml volumetric flask. So wash the container 2 to 3 times with 10 to 15 ml of water and add the washings to the measuring flask or volumetric flask. So make up the volume with distilled water up to 250 ml. So from this prepared solution, we will carry out two titrations. One for estimation of ferrous iron and other for estimation of total iron. So now if we subtract the total iron and ferrous iron, we can find out the amount of ferric iron present in the mixture solution. So here is the procedure for estimation of ferrous iron. So we have to take 25 ml of that diluted stock solution by using pipette to a 250 ml conical flask. Then we have to add 70 ml 6N sulfuric acid and 10 drops of N-phenyl anthranilic acid as indicator. Then we have to take in the burette 0.1 normal potassium dichromate solution and we have to start adding. And before that you have to take the initial burette reading in the burette. So the potassium dichromate solution was added to the solution till the green color changes to violet red. So once you get the violet red color, so at that point, that is the end point. So you stop the titration and you note down the final burette reading. Then the addition of potassium dichromate was stopped and the volume of potassium dichromate solution consumed was noted down. So you subtract final burette reading minus initial burette reading, that will give rise to the volume of potassium dichromate consumed. So the same process was repeated until three concordant readings were obtained. So here is the table where you note down your initial burette reading, final burette reading and the volume of iron solution from the stock solution we have taken each time 25 ml. And when you subtract final burette reading, FBR minus IBR initial burette reading, you will get the difference in ml. So that will be the rough reading. And again, you have to perform another three titrations that will give rise to your concordant reading. Similarly, here is the some approximate data are given. Suppose initial burette reading you took suppose 0.1 and FBR you get, let's say 24.9. So difference will be 24.8. And in the next iteration, suppose you start with initial burette reading 5.7 and you will get the final burette reading 30.3. So difference you will get 24.6. And in another next two iterations, suppose you get the difference 24.6. So 24.6 will be your concordant reading. Similarly, how to calculate or how to estimate the total iron? So 25 ml of the diluted or stock solution was pipetted out into a 250 ml conical flask. Then 6 ml of concentrated HCl was added. It was heated up to 60 to 70 degrees Celsius. Then concentrated SnCl2 was added dropwise till the color changes to light yellow. Then dilute SnCl2 was added dropwise till the color becomes colorless. Then the mouth of the conical flask was closed by means of a rubber cork in order to prevent the aerial oxidation of iron 2 plus to Fe3+ and cooled under tap water. Then 1 ml of HgCl2 was added, a silky white precipitate formed indicating the reduction of Fe3+ to Fe2+ is complete. So if a grey or black precipitate is formed by addition of HgCl2, then the reduction is not complete and you have to discard that solution and repeat the same procedure again. Then 70 ml of 6N sulfuric acid followed by 10 drops of N-phenyl anthranilic acid indicator was added if silky white precipitate is formed, which is the total iron in the mixture. So that means all Fe3+ is reduced to Fe2+ and already Fe2+ is as such is there. So the solution was titrated with standard n by 10 potassium dichromate solution till the green color changes to violet red at the end point. So at the end point, you note down the final burette reading, and initially you have noted down the initial burette reading. So now you can find out the volume of potassium dichromate consumed. And the same process was repeated until three concordant readings were obtained. So here is the table. So the volume of iron solution pipetted out was 25 ml. And you noted down initial burette reading. And you also noted down final burette reading. And you can get the difference. And here also you repeat the same titration for another three experiments. So you will get concordant reading. So here are some data. Suppose you start with the initial burette reading 0.1 and final burette reading you get 32.8. So the difference you will get 31.7. So this will be the rough reading. And in next experiment you will get 31.5. Let's say the difference. So in next two experiments also you get the same thing. So you get 31.5 as the concordant reading. So in calculation part, so 1000 ml of 1 normal potassium dichromate equal to 1000 ml of 1 normal iron solution. That is equal to 1 gram equivalent of iron equal to 55.8 grams of iron. So 1 ml of 1 normal potassium dichromate will be 55.85 divided by 1000 grams of iron. Similarly, 1 ml of n by 10 potassium dichromate will be 55.85 by 1000 into 1 by 10 gram of iron. So in the titration we have consumed 24.6 ml of potassium dichromate, so that will be equal to into 24.6. So 25 ml of diluted iron solution contain equal to 0.137 gram of iron, ferrous iron. Now if we multiply that with 40, so you will get 1000 ml. So 1 liter of diluted solution contain equal to 5.48 grams of iron. So therefore 1000 ml of solution contains 5.48 grams of ferrous iron. Similarly, if we calculate in the similar manner, so 1000 ml of 1 normal potassium dichromate equal to 1000 ml of 1 normal iron solution equal to 1 gram equivalent of iron, that is 55.85 gram of iron. So 1 ml of 1 normal potassium dichromate equal to 55.85 divided by 1000 gram of iron. So 1 ml of n by 10 potassium dichromate will be 55.85 by 1000 into 1 by 10 gram of iron. So in the titration, we get 31.5 as concordant reading. So 31.5 ml of n by 10 potassium dichromate will be equal to into 31.5 gram of iron. So this is present in 25 ml of diluted stock solution. So 25 ml of diluted stock solution contains 0.176 gram of total iron. So if you multiply that with 40, so we will get 1000 ml. So 1 liter of diluted stock solution will contain 40 into 0.176, that is 7.04 gram of total iron. So now if we subtract the total iron minus ferrous iron, so that will give you the ferric iron, Fe3 iron. So 1000 ml of solution contain only Fe3 iron will be equal to 7.04 minus 5.48 equal to 1.56 gram of Fe3 iron. So in conclusion, the actual amount of iron 2 and iron 3 present in the solution was found to be 5.48 and 1.56 grams per liter respectively. So we will be happy if you guys subscribe to our channel Chemistry Live UGPG, and this is also available in the website www.chemistrylifeugpg.com. So this is a simple step towards e-learning, making life better. So thank you all for learning.